Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn how the bistable multivibrator can be designed using the BJT. So in case of the bistable multivibrator, both states are stable state and the output of the multivibrator can be any of the two stable states. Now when we apply this trigger signal, then the output goes from one stable state to the another stable state. And if no triggering action occurs after that, then the output will remain in this second stable state. But suppose, if the triggering action occurs once again, then the output will go back into the another stable state. And it will remain in that stable state unless some triggering action occurs once again. So this type of bistable multivibrator can be used as a flip-flop. So now, let us understand how it can be designed using the BJT. So this is the circuit of the bistable multivibrator. And as you can see, here the two transistors are cross-coupled. That means the collector of the one transistor is connected to the base of the second transistor. And initially, when we power up the circuit, then one transistor will be on while the another transistor will be off. That means one transistor will operate in the saturation while the another transistor will operate in the cutoff region. So let us understand how the circuit works whenever we power it up. So initially after the power up, both transistors try to conduct. But let's say one transistor conducts more. For example, let's say this transistor Q1 conducts more. That means the collector current of this transistor Q1 is more. And because of this more collector current, the voltage drop across this resistor RC1 will be also more. So because of that, the voltage at the collector terminal will be less. And as the same voltage is also applied at the base of this transistor Q2, so the voltage which is appearing at the base of this transistor Q2 will be also less. So because of that, this transistor Q2 will conduct less. And due to that, the collector current IC of this transistor Q2 will be also less. So because of that, the drop across this resistor RC2 will be less, and due to that, the more voltage will appear at the collector of this transistor Q2. And as the same voltage is also applied to the base of this transistor Q1, so this transistor Q1 will conduct more and more, and eventually it will go into the saturation. So we can say that this transistor Q1 will act as a short circuit. And because of that, the voltage at the collector of this transistor Q1 will be approximately equal to 0. Moreover, the same voltage will also appear at the base of this transistor Q2. So because of that, this transistor Q2 will operate in the cutoff region and it will act as an open circuit. So because of that, the voltage at the collector of this transistor Q2 will be approximately equal to VCC. That means initially after the power up, the transistor Q1 will be on and the Q2 will be off. And in this condition, this output Q will be low while the output at the Q bar will be high. But depending on the which transistor conducts more, the reverse case is also possible. But in any case, when we apply the trigger pulse to the base of this transistor Q1, then it will set the output Q to the high. That means whenever we apply the negative going trigger pulse to the base of this transistor Q1, then this transistor Q1 will go into the cutoff region. And because of that, it will act as an open circuit. So in this condition, the voltage at the collector of this transistor Q1 will become high. That means we can say that this output Q will become high. And as the same voltage is also applied to the base of this transistor Q2, so this transistor Q2 will go into the saturation, and because of that, it will act as a short circuit. That means now, the output of this transistor Q2 will become low, or we can say that this output Q bar will become low. And as the same voltage is also applied to the base of this transistor Q1, so this transistor Q1 will still remain in the cutoff region. That means this output Q will remain high until we apply the reset pulse. So as soon as we apply the reset pulse or the negative going trigger pulse to the base of this transistor Q2, this transistor Q2 will go into the cutoff region. and because of that, it will act as an open circuit. That means now, this output Q bar will become high. And as you can see, as the same voltage is also applied to the base of this transistor Q1, so because of that, this transistor Q1 will go into the saturation. And due to that, it will act as a short circuit. That means in this condition, this output Q will become low. That means we can say that due to this triggering pulse, the output of the multivibrator has gone from the one stable state to the another stable state. So in this way, by applying the trigger pulse, we can set the output of this multivibrator in any of the two stable states. Now, when we apply the trigger pulse to these transistors, then it takes some time to come from the cutoff to the saturation region or from saturation to the cutoff region. So many times, to speed up this transition, the speedup capacitors are also connected in parallel with these resistors. So in this way, this bistable multivibrator can be used as a flip-flop, or it can be used to generate the gate pulse of the finite duration. For example, when the set trigger pulse is applied, then the output will go from the low state to the high state. And similarly, when the reset trigger pulse is applied, then the output will go from the high state to the low state. And the duration of the gate pulse will depend on the triggering instances of the set and the reset pulse. So in this way, we can generate the gate pulse of the finite duration. And this gate pulse can be used to control any other circuit or the instrument. So I hope in this video, you understood how the bistable multivibrator can be designed using the BJT. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.